ويقول الله عز وجل: يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم إن زلزلة الساعة لشيء عظيم يوم ترونها تدهل كل مرضعة عما أرضعت وترى الناس سكارى وما هم بسكارى ولكن عذاب الله شديد.
We are human beings. This is just a metaphorical exaggeration, which is good. We want to be motivated. He says, whomever know what Allah has prepared for the believers in Jannah, he will never sleep. If Allah show you a window like this, look at Jannah. Wallahi, you will never sleep. That's why the Sahaba, they saw it. Ashhadu, they saw it. Through the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he entered to Jannah physically, by the way. No one has entered. We have this. In Yawm al-Isra'i wal-Mi'raj, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam entered into Jannah. So he's not talking about just something he heard from Allah, which is sufficient. Sufficient, no. He physically entered Jannah, I came back. And he got a tour with Jibreel alayhi salam. Can you believe this? Yawm al-Isra'i wal-Mi'raj, and we talked about it in another time, took him and he gave him all this. And Salah was revealed on that Isra'i wal-Mi'raj. That's why they say because it's the gift from Allah. Don't treat Salat, because Salat actually it's the topic. Not topic, but it's the means. قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ تَذَكَّى وَذَكَرَ اسْمَ رَبِّهِ فَصَلَّى. So Allah did not forget to put dhikr and Salat in the word قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ تَذَكَّى. Successful indeed, the one who purified himself and rectified himself. فَذَكَرَ وَذَكَرَ فَصَلَّى. قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ تَذَكَّى وَذَكَرَ اسْمَ رَبِّهِ. And he remembered the names of Allah. How many names we have? إِنَّ لِلَّهِ تِسْعًا وَتِسْعِينَ إِسْمًا. Allah has 99 names. وَلِلَّهِ الْأَسْمَاءُ الْحُسْنَى. Just read those names of the attributes of Allah and see them and sit down by yourself. And when you say السَّمِيعُ, give it a touch, an inner feeling that Allah is hearing us now with His angels. They're watching. وَاللَّهُ رَقِيبٌ عَلَيْكُمْ رَقَابًا. Allah is overwatching. He seizes you. And this is maqam of al-ihsan. Ihsan is ta'bud Allah. Ihsan, which is excellence on your ibadah. And ta'bud Allah ka'annahu yarak. فَإِن كَأَنَّكَ تَرَاهُ. As if you see Allah. فَإِن لَمْ تَكُنْ تَرَاهُ فَإِنَّهُ يَرَاكُ. You see, even ihsan has two maratib. The excellence, it has two maratib. The first one is that you worship Allah as if you see Allah. And this is the highest level, which is the level of al-anbiya, al-siddiqeen. For the Prophet ﷺ, he says, if you cannot do this, if you cannot get to this level, that you worship Allah as if you see Allah. If we have this, wallahi, a man came and asked the Prophet, he says about mal iman. He says, al-iman an tara Allah fi kulli shughlik. Is to see Allah in every way you are, in every place you are. Not only in the masjid, but you see Allah everywhere. You are a worshipper of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the hidden and in the open. This is the true iman of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why Luqman al-Hakim, he gives his son an advice. He says, Ya bunayya, la takun waliyan lillahi fil alaniya wa aduwahu fil khala'. Don't be, what a beautiful advice. Luqman al-Hakim, Allah mentioned him in the Quran. This is Surah Luqman. وَإِذْ قَالَ لُقْمَانُ لِبْنِهِ وَهُوَ يَاعِظُهُ يَا بُنَيْ لَا تُشْرِكْ بِاللَّهِ. Oh my beautiful son, يَا بُنَيْ, do not associate partners with Allah. So if he's going, and then he says, he gave him an advice, he says, يَا بُنَيْ, don't be a wali of Allah, a good awliya. Allah is good to be the wali of Allah, the one who worship Allah, the way you dress, the way you look, the way you speak, in the alaniya, in the open. وَعَذُوَّهُ فِي السِّرِ, and his enemy in the hidden. No, be the same. Be the same, whether in the hidden, whether in the open. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching. Tazkiyatul nafs needs this muraqaba. It needs that, in order to purify yourself, you need to have this element of visualization of Allah. To be honest with you, this is the same thing we do on the dunya. So I'm not speaking theory. No, this is what we do. If I want to perfect my job, I want to visualize what I'm doing. You know, we know this. There's so many examples. You see what you want to do. The same thing in Islam. You see that Allah is watching you. That's how you excellent his your deed, and you perfect your deed the way it's supposed to be. And if, whenever we make a mistake, this is the open gate. يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, before he created Adam, and this is amazing. Allah, before He created Adam, He just fashioned him a clay and then let him to stay until he dries. Before He created him, He created a big door and He calls this Bab al-Tawbah. He created a door. He created the Bab, which is the door of Tawbah, repentance. Because He knows, and this is again back to how Allah, He wants you to repent. Wallahu yuridu an yatuba alaykum. Allah wants to repent on you. Allah is extending His hand. Come, come. Those who does, there is a beautiful ayah, those who extremely extravagant on themselves. قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَا الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الدُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا. What an ayah in the Quran. The ulama, some of them, they say the most hopeful ayah in the Quran. قُلْ يَا مُحَمَّدْ تِلْ يَا عِبَادِيَا الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا. He didn't say يَا عِبَادِيَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. He says, oh Muhammad, tell the people, to my people, عِبَادِي. He called them number one. He make them to myself. He says عِبَادِيَا. And then he says الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفِسِهِمْ. Put your imagination on the word أَسْرَفَ عَلَىٰ نَفْسِهِ. There is no sin that he did. He did shirk, yes he did. Because Allah says أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ. They went so far on destroying themselves. أَسْرَفُوا نَفْس again. And نَفْسُ الْأَمَّارَ بِسُوءٍ. Once you ride, once you should, the ulama, they say you should ride yourself. You ride your nafs. Otherwise, if your nafs will ride you, it will make every shar. You will go so deep. Shaitan will never be satisfied with one thing. He will go with one thing and go deeper, deeper. And we have many stories. That's why you have to be intact with Allah. Only Allah can save you from shaitan. Through His ilm and the knowledge and the revelation of the prophets and the messengers, you have to open your heart to this. You have to open the books and study. You have to sit down on your knee. You become doctor just like that? You become an engineer just like that? You want to go to Jannah for free? No. Same. Why we don't use? Allah created us to understand the language. This is Allah using the same language. وَالَّذِينَ جَاهَدُوا فِينَا لَنَهْدِيَنَّهُمْ سُبُولَنَا. Those who struggle on my path, I will surely guide them. But you show some struggle. You do something. You wake up, you do. You pray, you make dua. You say, Ya Allah, every day, between you and Allah, you will get the guidance. Even the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he used to make dua. Allahumma ati nufusana taqwaha. Ya Allah, guide my soul. Guide my heart. Ati nufusana, ourselves. Give me taqwa. Give me, who's this? The Prophet. Jibreel coming down with the Quran on him, but he's teaching the Ummah until the last day of this world. He's teaching us how humble he is. Never tell yourself, I'm good. I prayed, I'm fine. And this is a sign of shaitan is taking, or the self is taking you. A Muslim, true believer, he does the utmost. There is an ayah in the Quran that constantly we mention. وَالَّذِينَ يُؤْتُونَ مَا آتَوْا وَقُلُوبُهُمْ وَجِلَةً أَنَّهُمْ إِلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ رَاجِعُونَ. And those who يُؤْتُونَ مَا آتَوْا. Look at the Quran, it's amazing visualization. They did the most, everything they was asked to do,